Hey guys, welcome back to Airplane Anatomy, a series where I break down different airplanes from their history to their engineering to how they fly. So today in episode 5, we're going to be talking about one of the most powerful but elusive aircrafts in the world, and that is the Northrop Grumman B-2 Spirit. Now the B-2 was designed originally as a long-range bomber aircraft to carry both conventional and thermonuclear bombs. Now in order to do this, it needs to be able to enter and leave enemy airspace without being detected, especially by radar. This is also known as stealth. So today we're going to dive deeper into, in simplified terms, how does radar work, and also how are planes like the B-2 engineered for stealth. So let's get started. The development of the B-2, like many other military airplanes, started during World War II. So at that time, the US had two main bombers in their fleet. The first was from Boeing, called the B-52 Straddle Fortress, that was designed to fly at such high altitudes that it would be difficult to reach by anti-aircraft systems. And the second one, still in development at that time, was the Rockwell B-1 Lancer, which was designed to do the opposite. So it was supposed to fly at such low altitudes and so quickly that it would be difficult to detect. However, both of these airplanes had a big vulnerability to a new technology that was being developed in the 70s called radar. So with radar also came a new race to build the very first stealth bomber in the world. And at that time, Nazi Germany actually came up with a design for such an aircraft called the Horten-Ho 229, which was strikingly similar to the eventual designs of the B-2. However, thankfully, it was never put into service. So around 1979, the US started their Advanced Technology Bomber Program, or ATB program, which led to the eventual design of the B-2. So what was this new groundbreaking technology called radar, and how does it work? In simple terms, we can use radar to determine the position, the heading, and the velocity of an aircraft. Now, radar is actually an acronym for radio detection and ranging. And it might sound very complex, however, the concept behind it is actually very simple. Now, imagine you're holding a flashlight in a dark room. When you point that light towards an object, the light rays travel from that flashlight to the object and gets reflected by the object back into your eyes. And depending on which light gets reflected back and how much, this tells your brain what shape of the object it is and how far away it is. Now similarly, radar emit intermittent radio waves that can travel for many more miles and to a larger area. An antenna is then transmitting these waves as a narrow beam in a particular direction. Now this is why a lot of antennas actually rotate to track a movement in a larger area. Now these rays continue traveling until they hit something, in which case they will be reflected back. Now the antenna then can switch to being a receiver to listen to the radio waves that are returning. And since the waves travel at a constant speed, which is the speed of light, we can actually use the length of time it took for the wave to return to calculate how far away that object is. And there are many different types of radar as well. For example, the Doppler radar can actually tell you the heading of the plane depending on the change in frequency from the received wave. Now, this is similar to why the pitch of a fire truck siren changes as it approaches you and drives away from you. Now you may have noticed that there is an important assumption that we make in order for radar to work, and that is that the waves get reflected back to where they originated from. However, this is not always the case because there are ways for objects to actually absorb the radar waves or deflect them away from where they came from, and this forms the concept of stealth. One way that the B-2 actually deflects radar waves away from its origin is by using what is called a continuous curvature design. Now, in this design, the radii along each point on the surface actually changes in order to deflect the waves at all different directions. So this actually means that it required a tremendous amount of computing power in order to even come up with the simulations for this design, and this was also the reason of why B-2 was such an innovative plane for its time. On top of that, the engines were actually especially designed to be embedded within the aircraft with S-shaped engine inlets that were actually placed on top of the wing instead in order to reduce its radar signature from the ground. Now, all of this in combination with many other classified features made the B-2 actually have a radar signature of just 1.1 square feet, about the size of a large bird. However, all of these features weren't always active during flight, and pilots actually had to manually press a button labeled PEN, pen for penetrate, in order to turn on these features and literally disappear with a button. Now, how cool is that? Two companies competed to produce what would eventually become the B-2. The first was an aerospace manufacturer company called Northrop Corporation that partnered up with Boeing in order to compete against the design submitted by Lockheed and Rockwell. So Northrop at the time had actually developed two flying wings by the name of YB-35 and YB-49 that were very similar in design to the B-2. And so this was the design that eventually won against Lockheed and Rockwell. Now the B-2 is typically referred to as a flying wing, and that is because it doesn't have a traditional fuselage or even a tail section. So on typical airplanes, the tail section contains the rudder, which affects yaw movement of the airplane. So without a tail section, the B-2 actually relies on what is called a split rudder system that is located on the outer trailing edges of each wing. So how this split rudder system works is by slowing down, basically applying speed brakes on only one side of the aircraft and essentially creating that yaw movement. This was accomplished by what is called a fly-by-wire system, in which the pilot's inputs are interpreted by a computer, which then translates them into a series of actions for each flight surface. So in this way, the plane actually behaves as the pilot intends it to, even though some of the physical flight surfaces might be different. Both the design and the production of the B-2 were, of course, carried out in top secrecy. So Northrop actually created front companies to order materials with, and employees also had to get top secret clearance from a special branch of the Air Force, and also underwent random polygraph tests as they worked. There was also such thing as B-2 espionage, where two employees of Northrop actually decided to sell secrets of the B-2 program to other countries. So when they were caught, one was sentenced to life in prison and the other one 32 years in max security jail. So that was definitely a Wikipedia rabbit hole that I would highly recommend. Now, Congress originally intended to order 132 of B-2 planes. However, at the end of the Cold War, they decided to bring that down to only 21. Now, this means that on average, the cost of development and production for each plane was around $3.3 billion today. However, with that price tag, of course, the B-2 became one of the most powerful stealth bombers today, with its service ceiling of 50,000 feet and its max cruising speed of 0.95 Mach. It's also able to stay in the air for 6 hours without refueling, so this enabled it to, at one point, have a crew of two operate a mission for over 70 hours without needing to touch down on the ground. So there is definitely no dispute that this is an extremely powerful airplane. However, it has been a very long time since its original development, and of course, technology has advanced so much since then. As a result, Northrop Grumman has announced that they are working on a new stealth bomber by the name of B-21 Raider that is to enter service around 2023. And of course, the details around its design and production are highly classified. Thank you so much for making it to the end of this video. I hope you really enjoyed the B-2 Spirit as much as I did, and that it's your new favorite stealth airplane. So don't forget to give a like for this video and also subscribe to my channel. I've got a lot of great aviation content coming up for you guys. And I would love to see a comment from you on what you want me to cover next in my next episode of Airplane Anatomy. And so for now, I will see you next week.